Everybody, welcome back to the dumbest spy lab on all of YouTube, Pit Stain Hobbies. We're back with the Agora Models Lotus Submarine from The Spy Who Loved Me, based on the 1970s Lotus Esprit, and it is such a cool model. We've got pack three here with some parts. Looks like we got a piece of chassis here, and a whole bunch of little bitty engine bits. This is all going to be engine and transaxle. And a piece of frame, it looks like, in this pack of parts. So, let's get started. Alrighty, here we are with stage 17, part of the engine block. Let's get our X-Acto open. I really like the packaging for the James Bond models. It's particularly special with the extra branding involved. We got a big chunk of engine block right here. Nice and easy. Let's zoom on in a little bit so we can see what's going on here. Okay, so we got that. Got some DS05 screws. There's three in the bag, which means we're going to need two. You don't even have to read the manual for that one. Oh, pro tip. Don't squeeze the bag. I like to... there we go. We'll put that back in our little screw box when we're done. And we're going to just take this part. And... And then we're going to have it oriented like this, and we're going to put that little plate in there and then get two screws in there and there. So just give me one sec. Okay, so we got those in there, and now we got to take this little pipe just like this, and you just shove it into this little slot, and that's a good snug fit. But if you want, you can hit the back of it with a tiny bit of CA glue after you snip off the glued shut tip on there, and we'll just squirt a little. Squirtle! There we go. A little dab will do you. And that's it for 17. Might as well get out 18, see what we got here. Okay. And 18, we've got some more engine block. Shake your parts down. And there we are. Oh, we got an exhaust header. So, oh yeah, the exhaust. So this looks fine. I mean, it's clean, it's silver. You know, you could mess it up and brush it up and weather it, and you're never gonna see it. I'm always torn there on how much detailing to do to the engine. It's pretty nutty how OCD I get, but I'm just leaving the engines alone these days. I've got so many of these part works going, and I've got actual normal real scale model kits that I'm, you know, not working on very often. So I want to try to get some of this done. We're going to need the previously assembled top half of our engine, the cylinder head, and we're going to take this exhaust manifold, and there's a couple slots right here, and we're just gonna shove it right in, just like that. And then two PSO2 screws on those two tabs. So just give me one sec. Alrighty. Well, that's screwed in there nice. Don't go super crazy over tightening them. I was tightening down here, and I started to crack that little tab a little bit. You can just barely make out the crack. Yeah, you don't need to go Hulk Hogan on these things. So we're gonna take this in this orientation. We're going to take our engine block, and we're going to put this right here. So we have these two tabs right there, and we're going to get a couple of DS01 screws in there. So don't forget, maybe dip those in a little 3-in-1 oil since they're going in the metal. One sec. Okay, so those little guys are in there. Beautiful. We're going to turn this over. We're going to take this other engine part, and we're going to put it right down here. Oh, fits perfect. And then two more DS01 screws in these two holes there. Lighting and this shiny silver paint on the engine block does not play well with the camera. I'm sorry about that. One sec. Alrighty, we're back. This is done. Looking good. I just came up with a warning for everybody when unpacking these parts. So I was about to do this to pack 19 and then take this and go, foomp. And it turned out one of the pulleys had worked its way up into here, and just shaking it, it wasn't coming out. So double check that nothing's crept up into the top part of your packaging, or else you'll be emailing Agora Support going, "Who's part missing from my pack, man?" And maybe it was, but most likely it was this little pulley that got trapped behind the cardboard and stuck in there. So just a little tip for everyone. So let's see here. Actually, we're going to take this pulley. If you notice, it has a little... Oh, come on, focus. It's got a little indexing mark on it. And we're going to take this little fella, and it also has an indexing mark on it. And we're just going to shove them together. Come on. You know you want to... Yeah, there you go. Yeah, you wanted to be friends. You did. Okay. And we're going to take the front of this accessory cover, timing cover, whatever it is. And this is going to go onto the index hole. There we go. Butterfingers. And there's that indexing hole on there also. And we're going to just place that onto there. Then we're going to take this other little pulley. And it's going to go on here, on that indexing hole. There we go. Come on. Oh, you're texting me while I'm recording, babe. Okay. We're going to flip this over, and we got to get two PSO2 screws in. So I'll do those and reply to the text, and I'll be right back. Okay. So our little screws are in there. One, two. Now I got to take this fella and stick it onto the front of the engine. We're going to get this pin and that over this stud and that. And then, Dan, yes. And then a single DSO1 screw into this hole, right? Yeah. Oh, I forgot to put oil on this. That's okay. I went in fine. Oh, there we go. A little snappy down. There we go. Starting to get some pulleys on the front of that engine. Looks good. That's it for 19. This is going nice. At a nice pace. Just humming right along here. Okay, 20. Oh, spark plug wires. Oh, they're a little thicker than the average. Feel the top of that. Seem a little thicker than the average part work plug wire rubber tubing stuff. Now I'm all paranoid checking the top of all these. And let's see. Okay, clearly we've got an oil filter. Come on. Things focusing on. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, it's pretty nice. And some plastic doohickeys and a little distributor cap, it looks like. And we got a bunch of these little hoses. Five, to be in fact. Four are long and one is not as long. That's what we say to be nice these days. We don't call it the S word. I'm kidding, kids. It's shorter. Okay, there we go. Every group has one. Let me see. Actually, a couple of these are not as... There we go. See, we've got two different lengths of hose. So we've got the two longest hose, two medium hose, and one short hose. There we go. I've got all the hose. Okay, great. Good. Ba-dum-bum. We're going to take our engine here, and we're going to shove our two medium hoses onto these first two spark plugs. Kind of like the blue. It's a different color. Lotus, you crazy man animals, you blue. You're madmen, I tell you. Madmen. Blue wire. Now, I'm not putting craft wire in here because this tube is actually pretty nice. It has a good... It's not just folding over like it's made out of like Chinese rubber gloves or something. So I'm going to just leave that as is for now. If I later I determine I'll put some 22 gauge craft wire inside those tubes. I'm going to put one on top in the center of the little distributor cap. Let's get that on there. And these are all a fairly snug fits. That's why you don't see me throwing crazy glue everywhere just yet. If they decide to, you know, escape, then I will crazy glue them down. And now we've got to put all these hoses onto this little distributor. So we're going to hold the distributor like this. And then the rearmost hose is going to go on the bottom pin like this. These are a, yeah, they're a good snug fit on those posts. And then number two, do they want us to like weave these damn things in and out? I don't know. I'm just going to, number two is going to go there. And nope. Oh yeah. Yeah. Number two, that's fine. And then number whatever. Okay. Yeah. So this, it's fine. I don't foresee me opening the hood on this to show off the little dual overhead cam 4-cylinder engine. There we go. Okay. So we got all those little thingies like that. There we go. And now we're going to put together this oil filter housing assembly. And then let's see here. How does this one want to work now? Okay, so this little bell shaped thing goes on there. That's a good tight press fit. And then the big oil filter just squeezes onto there. That's kind of cool. Okay. And then we're putting this. This is the distributor thing, housing. And this is a D-shaped hole there. So it only goes on one way. And now, interesting. We're going to take this thing and kind of work it down over here. Huh? Oh, and under, hold on a second. I'm so confused. Does this thing go? Oh, there we go. I'm picking up what you're putting down. And then it fits into these two holes right there. Like that. There we go. If I get an angle, it doesn't blow out on camera so bad. So yeah, that goes like that. Oh, this must have been a really fun engine to work on for mechanics. Like, that's a packaging decision. Oh, you Brits, you crazy Brits, you. Back in the 70s, like, well, whatever, just fit it somewhere. All right, mate. No worries. I was Australian, sorry. that was funny. Okay, so that's it. We're not going to screw that part down yet. We got to get out stage 21. So we got here. We're starting to get some rubber bands and some more timing bits. Let's get 21 over here. Let's move this. Oh, nope. Careful. There we go. Put that over to the side for now. Just double check. Jeez, now I'm all. Yeah, I'm. There we go. Yeah, nothing there. Okay. Probably a better idea just to rip the cardboard off the top of the plastic bag before cutting it open. Those air holes in there, oh, those scare me. But nothing's ever gone missing, so never had a problem. This is like my, well, I mean, I've completed 3 Agora models, and this is Agora model number 5 I'm working on, because I also got the DB5 going, and then I'll have the Apache coming soon. That's going to be really cool also. That's going to be so cool. Oh, yeah. And oh please, come out with the absolutely stunning brute in a suit, the V8 Vantage from Living Daylights. I have to have that. That's my all-time favorite. The sub, the DB5, they're just right. They're right there, right behind it. But it was just something about, I think that was my age group, like Timothy Dalton. That was my dude. Pierce Brosnan, you know, he was good. I don't think there was ever really a bad James Bond. Well, except for, oh God, Lazenby. Honestly, he wasn't, he was just so jarringly different. I think that was the problem. He wasn't bad. He was just so different. But, Pierce Brosnan, Timothy Dalton was my favorite. I mean, Roger Moore, you know, Sean Connery was a legend. But when I grew up as a kid, like the movies that came out when I was a kid, that was Timothy Dalton. So I'm just, that's purely biased by my age. Even though I was named after Ian Fleming, thank my dad for that one. I could have been named Irving. Oh boy. You think I got problems now? Imagine if I was called Irving. Not good. Okay, let me get off my little diatribe there. Side stories. Okay, so we're going to take our timing gear here. Okay. I'm wondering how we're going to do this, because these are exposed timing gears. So we're going to take that. I'm going to put a PSO1 screw. Let me just do this one live for you. How are we doing the belt thing with the timing gears? I mean, again, I'm not going to open the hood, but I am curious because there should be a tooth timing belt of some form. Don't over tighten that. It's just, yeah, even really very little torque. It started spinning a little for me. It's fine. Everything's still solid in there, but I'm be careful. And then we're going to put together an alternator here. So we're going to take the little black alternator fan and have the fins, come on, fins facing up. I'm going to put the little black round center bit in there. And then we're going to offer this up to the silver alternator body. And a PSO1 screw from inside. By the way, if you're also building a DB5, my good friend Todd over at My Partworks has confirmed with Agora Models that if a DSO5 screw is on the DB5, the DSO5 screw is the same size screw on the Lotus Sub. So, God forbid you lose more than one of those extra screws, you can go steal it from your DB5 for the Lotus, or vice versa. That's a nifty thing. Okay, so now we got to put on the back body of, and you can see there's a thing there, and there's a little notch there, and those two are just gonna, ooh, that's a press fit. That's nice. I like that they used a few different colors of plastic and some paint to do up this alternator. It makes it look a little nicer than standard. So we're gonna take our alternator. Now is there an up and a down? Yes, there is. So there's two little round bumps there and one little round bump here, and that little round bump is going to go, the center one is going to go towards the engine block. So we got to line it up on those two holes and get a couple PSO1 screws in. Let me just knock that in there real quick. One sec. Alrighty. I just went down quite a little rabbit hole. We're going to put the oil pipe here on the engine and secure it with a PSO1 screw? Is that it? Yeah. I guess that's it. Let me get that screwed in there. And then, this is going to be a conversation. This should be fun. I started looking at the timing belt because I said, you know, it should be, you know, it's a cogged drive belt normally, almost always, for timing. And this is really a little fiddly right here, but yeah, there we go. And just snug. Don't go crazy with it. We might need to wiggle it just a little bit at some point in the future. So now what they want you to do is, there's a thin and a thick belt here. And you could tell by human eye, but this is the thinner belt, this is the thicker belt. It's really hard to see on camera the differences in thickness. But what they want us to do is to stretch this thinner belt around these pulleys. So there's, and around the, this is going to be a little on the fiddly side. To get this just Right. But we've got it. We got to slide that one forward a little bit. And so we're going to end up with that. Now, I was like, wouldn't it be cool if there was a cogged belt for that? And wouldn't you know it, my OCD and ADHD got the better of me, and I ended up on McMaster Cars website, McMaster.com. And what I did is I took a ruler, and I just started going around from corner to corner to corner to corner. And as I came all the way around, it looked like about 130 millimeters that the belt traverses. Now, this is a rubber band, so it stretches. Finding a small enough cog timing belt, I searched for scale model timing belt and other things like that. Scale model cogged timing belt. I kept getting like pilot seat belts and harnesses and stuff. Then I went to McMaster Car, and they have both 3 millimeter wide and 1/8 wide. I think 3 millimeters a tiny bit smaller than 1/8. And they have a 121 millimeter circle, a 132 millimeter circle. They're like $4 and change a piece. I'm tempted to order one and see if I could make it fit on here. I don't think the teeth would line up with anything, but man, wouldn't that be, that would be kind of cool. I'm not going to do that. But if one of you crazy animals, you know, gets a wild hair and wants to try that, little tiny cogged belts do exist. And we've got this one with no... There we go. We get that one on nice and easy. And that's good. Let me get back down to my instructions here. And I think that's it. Yes, that's it for this stage. So now let's grab 22. I know. It's those rabbit holes, you know, you fall into them all the time. So this is our new system. We're just going to rip the cardboard off, make sure there's nothing on top there, and then we'll cut it open. Much better idea, Ian. Much better. We got some air cleaner, intake plenum type. Oh, yeah, we do. Look at that. Airbox and airbox covers. Okay, we got some PS05 and PS14 screws. So we're just going to take this fella. And it's pretty clear which way it goes on, obviously, because we've got the little studs and little posts and all those things. And that's going to go right on there with a couple PS14 screws in those top two holes. So give me a sec. Be right back. Okay, well, we've got that screwed in, and it's an interesting pattern they have on here. It almost looks like carbon fiber, but this was like the 70s. I did some Googling. It might have been fiberglass. Who knows? I mean, maybe they could have taken pictures of a restored car that had an aftermarket carbon fiber intake box on it for whatever reason. But we're going to take the airbox cover here and put it right on there. There's a stud in the middle that it fits right into. And then we gotta throw a PS05 screw into that hole right there. So let me get that knocked out and I'll be right back. Okay, so that's screwed down. Make sure your little tubey thing goes into the little hole there. And you're all done with that. Stage 22. Let's get 23. Let's zoom out a tiny bit here. There's 23. We got a couple of back plates here for stuff. I'm not quite sure. I already broke my rule, but I looked at the parts list. There's everything's down in the baggie here. This couple of plastic parts here and a bunch of PS02 screws, which we've already got some extras of here, but I'll just open these up and let's see what we got to do here. Okay, so let's get a bunch of these out. I'm assuming I need like 5 or 6 because there's usually at least one spare. We're going to take the engine in this orientation. We're going to take this plate in this orientation. And we're going to get 2 PSO2 screws in here. Wrong screwdriver, Ian. There we go. I got the number PH1 and the PH0 out because a couple of the screws you need a smaller screwdriver for. I mean, you could technically do them all with a PH0, but, you know, they'll cam out on you and you could potentially strip a screw head. So right screwdriver for the right job is what I say. I'm putting that on there. Easy enough. Now we're going to take our transaxle. And we're gonna put it right over those two holes there. And two more PSO2 screws. Okay. We don't have a heck of a lot left to do on this build. On this section of the build, I mean, on this pack of the build. What should I say? Cheesy. That's okay. No one comes here for your smooth tones and articulation. They come here to listen to you in the background and make them feel smarter than, you know, they normally would, because they're like, oh, this guy, he's a piece of work. Yes, I am. That's what my wife says all the time. My wife. So here we go. Put this other plate on here. And it looks like, yeah, two more PSO2 screws. And that stage went very smoothly. It's a really interesting little engine. You know, why is a gasoline engine called an engine, but car racing is called motorsport instead of engine sport? But if you're talking about electric car, it's an electric motor, not an electric engine. If you call a car engine a car motor, somebody's going to come out of the woodwork, probably my friend Eric, and be like, it's an engine, not a motor, you dummy. And I just wonder. That is a really curious-looking engine block, I got to say. Maybe there's more to it. It's probably an oil pan that goes on this thing. Let's just keep scrolling through the instructions. 24, yes, okay. I could have just looked at the parts. Yes, there is an oil pan. I was like, where does it crank and all that? I don't know. What is going on? Is my desk getting loose from the wall? Because the camera seems to be shaking more. Probably because I'm also zoomed in a bunch. And the steady shot on this Sony is trash. I like this Sony ZV-1. It's a really, really good camera. Its autofocus abilities, well, they've been better. I don't know. It seems like it's getting long in the tooth, the age of it. Let's see. It should fit on just like that. But yeah, I don't know. I gotta figure something out with my camera setup. Like, everyone's getting nauseous watching. Oh, I'm jumping the gun here. So we've got to put these two little panels onto the oil pump. And if you notice, they have a bit sticking out on one side. Those are going to go in. And the countersunk screw holes, see, they're countersunk. Those face out. And we need to get four, obviously, itty-bitty little PS27 screws in there. Let me get those in. I'll be right back. Okay, so we got those little four screws in. We're going to throw this right on here now, on those two studs. Get a couple of these. Wrong screwdriver. I was just using the PH0 for those little tiny screws. Come on, stop rolling all over the place. Don't make me fight you. There we go. This all fits together very nicely. Nice and easy. There we go. Stage 24 is done. Now that looks a little more normal, even though the engine is all off at like a 45-degree angle. I wonder if that had any issues with... No, it's just... I mean, it's basically just half a V8 at that point, the four-cylinder. So that's pretty cool. I like the oil filter in there. You guys could have some fun really weathering this up. That exhaust, that could be fun to weather up. You know, you could just put a little sooty stuff or whatever colors on there. And now, and then, we've got this box right here. This is the last of pack three. This is stage 25. And it's a nice big honking chunk of die-cast metal. So that's cool. Of course, the box didn't go where I wanted it to. But yeah, there we go. Beautiful. Absolutely gorgeous. And I think I lost the screws. Okay, well, we've got plenty of spares. So let's see what we got here. PSO5 screws. Do I have some of those? Got one here. I could have sworn I had more. I must have dropped the screw bag. I know I took it. I saw it for a second. Well, either way, this is why we keep our extra screws. So we'll need one of our previous spare PSL5s because I'm an idiot. There we go. That's why we keep them in this little bead organizer thing that we got off Amazon. Link below. Agora's link is below. I don't know if I even said that in the beginning of the video. It's kind of obvious it's down there. But yeah, click the links below. Helps out. And we're going to put the engine on this center backbone of the chassis here. And there's these two holes here and here. And they're going to go right down there. Wow, that's getting to be gonna be kind of long. And we're going to get these in here. And these are plastic, I think. So, snug, but don't go crazy. I'm not even on camera. Snug, but not crazy. Crazy snug. Don't over-snug. I want to pet the rabbits, George. Yep, he over-snugged the rabbits. And there we are. And that is it for pack 3 of the Lotus Esprit sub. And we're at just over 14 inches long, or 70 millimeters, give or take. Yeah, nice. This is a heavy chunk of metal. This is really solid. You beat someone with this thing. There we go. I think the engine would probably snap off if you really whacked someone hard with it. But that being said, these are meant to be display pieces only and not functional weapons of war. So there we are. Thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the build. I hope you're signing up for the build. It's a really cool one. Again, links are below. And really, really cool. This is the first four-cylinder offset weirdo British engine I've ever built. So it's pretty nice. If you're interested in going on the rabbit hole for a toothed cog belt, be my guest. You might have to trim it down widthwise. But McMaster Car apparently has 16th of an inch wide and 3 millimeter wide, and like I said, approximately 130 millimeters should get around all these pulleys. You may want to go a little smaller and stretch it a bit, or I don't know. I don't even know if it would work. I mean, honestly, it would only, you would know it's there, because when, you know, this is the back of the car, so when you do open the trunk, you're gonna see that. And in here, I don't know if you're gonna see this too much. But either way, I love exposed timing belts and timing cogs. Oh, those are pretty sweet. Thanks for coming. See you next time. Adios, everybody.